Let's talk about fibroadenomas today. Fibroadenomas are the most common lumps found in adolescent girls. They usually occur under the influence of hormonal changes that the girls undergo at the time of puberty, and they happen because of overgrowth of glandular tissue in the breast. They usually present as simple, mobile, painless, smooth, well-defined lumps. They can be present in one breast or in both the breasts. They could be single or they could be multiple also. Majority of the times they remain stable in size. They do not really increase or decrease. However, a few may even reduce over time once the hormonal influences wear off. So what is important in such cases is diagnosis. And diagnosis in young girls is obviously by the means of sonography. Sonography can diagnose the fibroadenomas perfectly. However, for histopath correlation, we need to do a core needle biopsy. And in older ladies, we also prefer to do a mammography because we would like to rule out any cancerous lump also in those cases. After the diagnosis is confirmed and it is sure that this is a fibroadenoma, then the treatment depends upon the size of the fibroadenoma, whether it is causing any symptoms or whether there are any other problems because of the fibroadenoma. There is no medical treatment for fibroadenomas. There are no medicines to decrease the lumps specifically. They may, however, as I mentioned earlier, reduce on their own also. So the most important thing to do is to keep these fibroadenomas under observation and follow-up. The patients are told to come after 3 to 6 months. We repeat a sonography to see whether the lumps are increasing or are they stable in size. If they are stable, nothing more needs to be done. They can be kept under follow-up every 6 monthly. And if they are increasing in size, then we need to do something about it, maybe a surgical excision. However, surgical excision is not required in all the cases. It is required only in 3 conditions. First, as I said, if the fibroadenoma is increasing in size. Secondly, if it is becoming very painful for the patient. And thirdly, if there is any confusion in diagnosis between the fibroadenoma or any other condition, then it is always better to take the lump out. And there is a new method that is recently come into medical practice, and that is a vacuum-assisted fibroadenoma resection. This is done by a specialized equipment known as a VAB machine. This is a needle attached to a suction tubing. And what we do is give a little local anesthetic procedure. It is an OPD procedure, takes about 15 to 20 minutes. Patient is awake and very comfortable during the procedure. So local anesthetic is given to make the area numb. A small cut about 3 millimeters is made into the skin. And this special needle is introduced into the skin, goes to the area of the fibroadenoma. This procedure is done under ultrasound guidance. So under the ultrasound, we take the needle to the fibroadenoma and then we start resecting it. So the needle inside, it cuts the tissue, it rotates, and it sucks out the small bits of fibroadenoma into the suction machine. And the whole tissue is gradually taken out like that through a hardly 3 millimeter incision. This is a very safe procedure. Only risk is that of bleeding, and that we take care of. A good compression for about 10 minutes will take care of all the bleeding. And then the tissue that is resected is sent for histopathological correlation, and nothing more really is needed after that. So this is a new method, and however, it is not suitable for all the cases. Only fibroadenomas which are smaller than 2 centimeters and not very close to the skin or the chest wall, these are the ones which are suitable for VAB resection, and it can be done for these patients. So as I said, the most common modality for treatment for fibroadenomas is just observation and follow-up, and a surgical resection and a VAB resection is required only for the very few people in which the fibroadenomas are increasing or painful.